And now this is actually the view from the other side of the train. Pretty cool train ride. That shit moves fast as hell.
Oh wait, it's going that way? I thought it was going that way.
Yeah, those people are supposed to be in there.
Right there, it probably had like a little island thing, and it ran off to the side, and then goes up. Like that one, the one spot on going to warm waters, they had like loads there.
Thank you. back to Oxbow curve again, folks. So if you missed that oil pipeline that the children had to walk across, you can look to your left right here, and we'll be going underneath it very shortly.
What?
Yeah.
connect to this very old tunnel coming up right over here. Now this tunnel was all cut out by Andrew's number two. We used to cut this tunnel out of the solid rock. Now right here, look to your left, you'll see the tunnel. And if you come over here, you can walk through it. Right here, look over, it's the mountain. Now to get into that tunnel, right up here is this parking lot. Look back over your left shoulder and you'll see the entrance. Now the entrance is pretty small. It's not real big. Now right when we go up here, now look over your left shoulder, you'll see the entrance back there a little bit. Now the entrance isn't as big as what you saw the exit is. What they tried to do is try to close it up at one time. Me being a local, we just kept digging it out. So there is a spot for you to get in there yet.
Give me sides.
Now here we're going to be crossing the bridge again for the last time. So if you look to your left, you'll see the town of Jim Thorpe sitting down the banks of the Lehigh. And if you look to your right, right here, you'll be looking straight down into the Lehigh River. Thank you.
juice.
And now if you look to your left there, you'll see a flagpole. That's not a flagpole at all, it's actually a cell phone tower. But the reason why I bring that up is because that's the entrance to the Lehigh Grove State Park. Now if you want to take a walk through the tunnel or just visit the park over there, you go across the Route 903 bridge. As soon as you get to the end of the bridge, take the first left, go down and up that hill there, and you'll come to that flagpole. Right at that flagpole, turn left and drive right down, and you can walk through the tunnel, do a little hiking or biking. And now we're back at the Drifter Freight Yard again. So if you look to your right, you'll see the turntable there. Now that's used for turning our steam engine again, like I mentioned before. What happens is they pull the whole engine and the tender on there, and they spin it completely around in a circle. And also on the left here, you'll see a couple of cabooses in here that people have parties in them over the summer. They're all privately owned. And they look kind of crummy from the outside, but some of them are actually nice on the inside. There's a couple of our freight guys over there. And right off to your right is the gondola car. That's where we bring your bicycles when we take you on the bike trail. And those maroon colored cars again, they were built in 1917. They're 101 years old this year. And then we use them for our Christmas train. We have like a little polar press that comes through and gives each kid a little treat. We have reindeers coming through. Snowman, really a night action, atmosphere, and those very old cars. And don't forget, any of you folks from Philadelphia, I hope to see you down there on Sunday for my bike race. Now, on behalf of the Lehigh Grove State Railway, I'd like to thank you for taking the trip today, and hope you had a pleasant time. Now, please exit the train only where the uniformed car is except on present. Watch your step, and when you're ready, have a safe and enjoyable trip back home. Now, I'm not sure if I mentioned that Jim Thorpe won the decathlon of decathlon in the 1912 Olympics. Now, he won those medals, but the Olympic Committee found out he played baseball for $2 a week. So what they did is they stripped his medals from him. Now, what happened is, in the mid-1800s, they gave his medals back to him. Now, he was passed away by then, but his family received them. So if you want to see some of his medals, you can go actually in the Jim Thorpe National Bank. Now, they won't try to sell you nothing, I promise. You just go in the bank. There's a big display case there with some of his medals along with his family. And it's really cool back then to see the medals because the ones are so big right now. But back then, they were as big as a dime, or maybe the biggest one was about the size of a quarter. I think you have about 19 or 20 of his medals in there. And every May, his grandsons come here. And they ride the train, and we have a birthday celebration in the park for them, and with Native American dancers, and they actually ride the train with us. And once we stop down here, what they're going to do now is they're going to disconnect the engine from the caboose and bring it back up to the front of the train. So if you stick around at the railroad station there, you'll get to see the engine come right up in front of the railroad station there. And again, on behalf of the Lehigh Grove Scenic Railway and its employees, I'd like to thank you very much for riding.
The train ride from the other side. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. This content was brought to you by Nine Finger Gaming. Thank you.